Hello everyone. So here we are with the full Raspberry Pi kit from Maplin. Everything's wired up and you can see it's powered on at the moment. So I'll give you a quick tour of everything on the board. Basically we have a small mini computer with a 700 megahertz ARM processor, A6 I think, with 512 of RAM. The original board came with 256, this one's now 512, does make a big difference. Here is our micro USB used for power, and that's plugged into a power brick, plugged into a wall socket. Our HDMI connector is here, and this is a USB. 3.5mm jack, forgotten what that is, basically an AV jack, Ethernet, and then this is a set of riser pins which you can use for an expansion board for connecting sensors and all sorts of other crazy stuff too. I'll be looking at that in future. And down here, on the flip side of the board as it were, is an SD card slot. And that's actually where our operating system for the Raspberry Pi runs from. Doesn't use hard drives, doesn't use SSD drives as such. It uses just memory sticks, memory cards, nice and cheap. You also got in the kit a powered USB hub, and that's for holding obviously all of your USB devices like the Wi-Fi, the keyboard and the mouse that comes in the kit. I've also plugged in a USB memory stick to allow me to grab films, music or whatever directly off a USB. The whole thing took about half an hour to get wired up and kind of figure everything out. You don't get a massively expansive instruction guide or anything like that. It's just a single sheet of paper which tells you how to plug everything in a basic fashion and get it up and running. I gave the Raspberry Pi operating system that comes in the box a try. It wasn't really suitable for the project I had planned. I wanted to turn this into a home theater PC first and foremost. So I did away with the software that comes with the Raspberry Pi and downloaded something called XBMC. And basically it's a home theatre interface really for all of your media. So it plays things like your MP4 video files, your MP3s, lets you access to your video, your pictures and images, but also can have add-ons which allow you to tap online resources like Flickr or YouTube. So it's just really, really useful. In all, it took probably about half an hour to get this system up and running with all the bells and whistles and with Raspberry MC or RaspMC on there. Shout out to the creator of RaspMC as well because it's fantastically well done. He's done a really good job on it and it shows what younger developers coming into a new hardware platform, getting cracking on it, can come up with. Absolutely fantastically well done. So overall as a kit, I have to say really, really impressed. Not only is the Raspberry Pi a fantastic little board and very, very powerful as well, as you're going to see in a second, the kit itself has everything I needed and just worked straight out of the box. No mucking around, no configuration, even the little Wi-Fi dongle plugged in, detected, off it went. No messing. The keyboard I found to be really, really nice as well, and the mouse likewise. Whilst a little bit light and plasticky, does the job. Overall, a really, really good package for 75 quid that Maplin have put together here, and well worth it. The only thing you don't get is obviously the memory stick, but everything else here, the Raspberry Pi, the memory card, all of the cables, mouse and keyboard, the hub and the Wi-Fi dongle, all comes in the kit for 75 quid. Absolute bargain. And now let's have a look and see what the Raspberry Pi is capable of. This is the RaspMC interface. This is not the standard Raspberry Pi that comes in the box, which is based on Debian Wheezy, I think is the build. Which in itself is a perfectly good operating system, but I needed something that looked great on the television set and provided that home theatre experience. So, with XBMC, you get all of the usual features of that particular system, including being able to open up any kind of media you like. So as you can see, this is the Raspberry Pi playing back a 1080p video file of the Avengers that I ripped. And it's absolutely flawless. This is a £25 computer playing back perfect, flawless 1080p. I'm afraid that's all I can show you without breaking copyright law, but it gives you a sense that for £25, you've got a perfect home theatre PC here. So as you can see, the Raspberry Pi is an incredibly powerful little machine. Any system that can play back 1080p video is fine as far as I'm concerned. To actually install RaspMC, you need to run an installer ideally on Windows or Mac with a memory card reader your SD card inside that reader, and then the software will copy on the installation files effectively. You'll then need to have your Raspberry Pi plugged in onto an Ethernet cable and plugged into the internet. Boot up that memory card you've just installed the files onto for RaspMC and let it do its thing. And it takes around 20 minutes and then you'll have this available basically. A really, really good and practical use for the Raspberry Pi if you're looking to do something a bit more than just programming. You know, if you wanted to use these really as embedded devices for, you know, home theatre PCs and things like that, absolutely spot on for it.